Welcome to your 2020 ride, booty edition. You got 20 minutes of intervals on the bike, and then we'll do 20 minutes working the glutes on the floor. Start here out of the saddle. Right leg takes the lead. Your hips right over the pedals, your abs up and in. Inhale some good energy. Exhale, relax your shoulders down. Little bend in the elbows, hands are light. Tap it back, go. Two and one, hold it center, turn up. Make sure you've got enough resistance. Really important on this ride, tap it back, give me four. Three, two, press it down the middle, go. Good, oblique squeeze, right? Left. Let's do four each, press four. Obliques four. Back to press. Hey! Tap it back four. Let me meet your mama. If you got another bitch, don't put me. Press four, go. Obliques. Tap it back. Love it. Press, press, go. Obliques. Tap it back. She's a masterpiece. Two more. Reach down, turn it up. Hey. Three stacks of peace. And every time I get the hit, she get the bread from me. Tap. Just your tap. Hold it. Good. So you know that I say at the start of every class, you can do the entire ride in the saddle. Same applies here. Keep your butt up if you're out. We'll take this on the left leg. Turn it up. Good. Big, big turn up. Make it heavy. This is a two-song hill. So as I was saying, you can do this in the saddle if you need to. I want for you to know, especially on a climb or a sprint or a push, when you're out of the saddle, you are working your glutes more effectively. When you're in the saddle, it's more of your quads and your hamstrings. So especially when your butt is back and you're hinging from your hips, you're recruiting your glutes, okay? So add some more resistance. Take it back for four, go. Good. So your abs are tight, you reach back. Good. Now get a little lower. I'm just trying to see something. I ain't gotta say it cause I know. Level up, let's go. Turn up. Use your abs to support your spine. Hands are light. You never ever rest your elbows on those bars. Rise up. Travel back for four. Go. Good. So if you're doing this right, you should definitely be feeling this in your glutes. Two back. And just notice the difference. And if you sit in the saddle, you'll feel like your quads are doing more of the work, right? Okay, so this is a booty ride. So we really want to focus on that. Which good news is, you're back to four back. If you are a new rider, coming out of the saddle is easier when you've got a lot of resistance and you're going slower. So really try and work that out of the saddle. Good. Okay. Right leg, more resistance. You see how breathless I am? And I've got to hold back a little bit so that I can talk. So push your limits. Get uncomfortable with it. Make it feel like a light press. Right, left. Again, your butt is back. Get a little lower. Four low, go. Inhale up. Exhale low. Twos. Yeah, you can add a little swerve. As long as you're pushing your tail back and you've got the resistance where you're feeling this incredible burn on your posterior chain. Good, tall. This, we're giving your ass a break for a moment. So if you're one of those riders that's like super upright, I'm trying to think, is it the Le Mans bike? So many people ride that upright. You are not working your butt at all, four low. So just keep that in mind. There's nothing wrong with the Le Mans, but I would definitely recommend taking the bars lower so that you are working your glutes and you're working your abs too. So when you go low, you push your tailbone back. Okay? Good. Three. Two. Good. Hold low. Good. One, two, four, low. Bring it up. If you are feeling a little too intense on your low back, you probably have too much resistance on. I appreciate your ambition, but if it's tight on your low back, that's a little bit too much. Also, you definitely want to stay on the beat. This is a rhythm ride. Yeah. Good. Hold it low. Right hand back. Pull your belly in tight. Four, three, two, switch. Good. You feeling that? Good. Both hands down. Whew. All right. We made it to the top of our first hill. Have a seat. Finding your base resistance. Same thing applies here. We want to be using resistance even on our sprints because you're not going to do anything to benefit your ass if you don't have any resistance on the wheel. So this song, just over 5 minutes long, we're going to do Tabata drills. So right here, just move your legs. So you guys said that you really like the red light, green light. So that's how we'll do it. Red obviously means stop. Don't worry about what you're doing. Like, keep your legs moving for sure, but don't worry about being on the beat. Okay, you've got about 20 seconds before we start. Add just a little bit more resistance. And if you need to recover, you sit up tall, you take a deep breath in, you can even bring your hands up over your head. Whatever you need to do. Three, two, one. Green light, let's go. 20 seconds on. Now with the resistance that you have, maybe you're just pushing up to hit the beat. That's where I am right now. You got 9 seconds. And the first one's supposed to feel relatively okay. Three, two, one. Red light. You got 10 seconds. Do what you gotta do to feel better. Good, let's go, 20 up. Yes. Big push. Upper body is calm and quiet. Your legs are doing the work. This gets to a point where you feel any sort of comfort, turn it up. Three, two, one. 10 seconds, feel better? Hey, 3 seconds. Breathe in. Breathe out, 20 on, let it up. Come on. Think about the perfect pedal stroke, okay? So you're not just hammering down. Pull up, kick over the top. Three, two, one. Recover, 10 seconds, feel better. Sit up tall, you breathe, relax your shoulders down. Going again in three, two, one. 20 on, let's go. Okay, if you haven't added anything yet lately, let's do it. Keep the tension out of your upper body. Relax your face. 5 seconds. Three, two, one. 10 to recover. You want to stand up, march it out, do what you gotta do? Let's go, 20s. Light it up, light it up. Hey! Come on. Remember, mindset of an athlete. Athletes don't coast. We don't do that. 3, a little faster. 2, 1, 10 seconds recover. Woo. How you doing? All right, 20 up, push. Good, level up. You better be sweating. You better be breathing heavy. Pull your abs in tighter. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Red leg. Okay, we're getting close. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Green light. 20 seconds. You can do anything for 20 seconds. Slide your heels back. Knees pointing straight ahead like headlights. Level up. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Breathe.
Yes. Let me show you how to do it.
5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Go, go, go. Good. Think about engaging your inner thighs. Come on. I want you breathless. Turn it up. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Red light. Three, two, one. 20 on. Green light. Biggest, most powerful push in this song right here. Hands are wide so you can breathe deeply. 10 seconds. Come on. Dig deep. You have that strength. You gotta tap into it. 3, 2, 1. Good job. Amazing. Okay, right leg. Wow. We're gonna add more resistance. Rise up. You see how slow it is. This is gonna be really heavy on your resistance. Put your shoulders down your back. Okay, again, we're scooting the hips back. Good.
Low, put it in the dirt.
Add it again.
Put it in reverse. Put it in a hearse.
Okay, so watch it here. We're gonna do it diagonal. So it's left shoulder to right hip. Your feet have to be a mirror image of mine so that you're going the proper direction. So right here, your butt is reaching back to that right back pocket. Add a side to side, back. Good. Are you breathless? So really focus. Think of this almost like a single leg squat. Okay, so you really power through as you go back to that back corner. Power. Good. Ha. Good. Last one. Okay. Then we gotta get the other side. Okay, do you see how I've changed the diagonal? Right shoulder, left hip. Right shoulder, left hip. So now the focus is on the power through on the left leg extension. Good. Reach your butt back. So you're kind of compressing, that your tailbone is reaching back. You're bringing your chest towards your knee. Good. 2, 1, add your side to side. Back, side. Yeah. Keep it up. You're doing amazing. Good. 8. Hands stay light. You zipped up your abs, pull them in.
They make you my enemy.
Good. We even out the legs in 4, 3, 2. Both even. Level up. Good. Little lower elbows floating above the bars. Four low. Bring it up. So you thought all this time I was just having you dance when we go low. I'm working your underbutt. Good, turn it up again. Low, abs tight, rise. Relax your shoulders. Two, push it back. Two, yeah. Last one, beautiful. We made it to the last song. We have 3 30-second pushes. You have the option in or out of the saddle. I'm sorry if that sounds like a broken record, but I do just want anybody who hops in to any of my classes just to know that it's okay for them to ride and that I welcome them into any ride that I do and just to take it where they need to. Okay, here we are. Right or left leg, don't stress that. Here's the buildup. Ask yourself, do you have the resistance you need? I'll ask you again. Do you have the resistance you need? All inhale. Exhale out. Ass up. I want for you to do in the saddle, and we're going to add a lot more resistance. So, this is your last opportunity to rise if you're going to follow with us. So, take a deep breath in. 30 seconds. Let's go. Come on. We got this. We're in it together. Double back. Single. Single. Two. Two. Single. Single. Let's go. Again, knees pointing straight ahead. If your hips are even thinking about lifting up, you need more resistance. Don't be afraid of it. Turn up. Just like I gotta tell you not to be afraid of your greatness, don't be afraid of resistance. Your greatness can handle the resistance. A little faster. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, now it is time to work the booty on the floor. I have some 10-pound weights that I'm going to use. You can use weights. If you don't have weights, you don't need to use weights. So we are gonna start right here with a curtsy squat. So your feet are going to be at your athletic stance, little bend in the elbows. And you're gonna take your foot back and just stepping back here. Yeah, it's gonna hit the light. Good. So just taking the curtsy and just go as low as you can go. Good. You can also float the leg if you've got the balance for that. I'm just gonna demonstrate it this way. Also, you can rest the weights on your shoulders if you prefer to do that. So you just want to take a nice deep bend. You want to make sure that the knee doesn't go in front of the toes, your front knee. Really important that we keep the knees safe when we're doing any sort of exercise. So just always being conscious and making sure that the knees don't go beyond the toes. Beautiful, okay. So now we've got good mornings. I'll show you how it looks from here. Little bend in the knees, and you're just gonna have a slight bend and you come up. You're squeezing your butt. If you have heavier weights, I highly recommend using heavier weights, okay? We wanna develop the muscle, and light weights aren't really gonna do that. So if you have the opportunity, the availability to grab some heavier weights, I highly recommend you doing that. Now notice that my back is so flat. You've got that perfect neutral spine, and then you really, really wanna engage. Squeeze your butt at the top. Just like when we do that bicep curl, we pause at the top just for a moment and just make sure that we're really firing the muscle and getting the muscle fibers fatigued so that they can build and they can grow. Good, let's do two more. Good, and squeezing your shoulders back. So make sure that you're not hunching at the top. Okay, so now we go back to that split squat. Supersets, because we've got 20 minutes. I'm gonna maximize your time. This is how I roll, this is how I train. My ADHD is way too bad for me to sit still and recover. So if that's something that you need to do, know that you can, but it's Holly Superset. That's my middle name. Good. And really, we wanna just fire up and fatigue the glutes. Supersets are definitely the way to do that. Good. Spine is tall, abs engaged to support your spine. You're doing great. Now, remember with your breath, you're exhaling on the hardest portion. So you exhale as you're coming up. Really feel your glutes fire as you come up. Good, one more each side. Ha, beautiful, ready. So shoulders back. This new booty. Good. Down. Up. Down. This new booty. Down. Up. Ha. Get it right. Ha. Because this is your back, tempo is a little bit fast. So we're gonna release that knee to be on the beat. Down, up, squeeze your butt, shoulders back, keep that flat back. If you've got a mirror, please check your form. Up, two, last one, facing forward. Weights can come up, they can stay at your side, whatever feels best for you. Y'all ready? Last set. Four, three, two, step back, go back, up. Yeah. Nice. So, I'm sure you've heard of skaters, and that is the plyometric move that you're doing, obviously without weights, which is another beautiful way to just burn your glutes in a big way. So if you're ever doing high intensity intervals and you're doing plyometrics, be sure and incorporate those skaters. They're my favorite. Such a great way to work your glutes. Good. Keep it going. Yes, breathe through it. Bring your focus. Make sure your glutes are doing the work and not your quads. Good. You got it. Two. And one. Good. Okay. Your feet are wider. Little bend in the knees. Go. Down. Rise and squeeze. Down. Rise and squeeze. Little bend in the elbows as well. Nothing is locked out. bringing your focus, your attention to the underbutt. Right? Ah. Good. Inhale. Exhale. Good. Now we're going three counts. One, two, three, up. One, two, three, up. Two, three. If it's too fast, go at your pace. This new booty. Two, three. Two, two, three. Last one, we reverse it. One, two, three, down. One, two, three. Two, three. One, two, three. Half stay tight. And if you don't go all the way down, that's okay. Ideally, you want to get that good stretch. But flexibility is going to play an issue, right? One, two, three. Good. Beautiful job, you guys. Okay. Now, we're going to do what everybody knows is the glute bridge. And I'm super sweating, so use a towel here. So you're lying on your back. Oh my God. It's a mic. Okay, so hope I didn't kill that. You're gonna bring your right foot, or I'm sorry, your right knee into your chest. Left foot is pressing into the ground. You're gonna lift and lower. Lift and lower. Pressing through your left heel. Exhale, inhale. Now, you definitely don't want to be using your elbows to press in. Lift, lower. Abs tight, hips are even. Really pressing. And I want you to think about pulling the pelvic bone up towards your sternum, okay? So what does that mean? You're tilting your tailbone under so that when you lay down, when you're down flat, you don't have that natural arch that you would. Two. Good. It's the heel. Do you see that I'm floating my toe? Let's switch. Lift. Good. Up. And you may notice that you can come up higher on one side or the other because of the flexibility on one side versus the other. Exhale. Really squeeze, fire the glutes. Yes. Keep it going. Lift. Drive your hips as high as you can. Okay, now you're gonna take the bottoms of your feet, bring them together. Your knees are out. Ready, flatten your back and lift up, go. Lift. This is such a good look, right? So if it distracts you, if you can just do this, and you're not actually pressing into the floor. This is all about your medial glutes. So for as obnoxious as it looks, it is really, really valuable, especially for runners and cyclists, because we aren't using the glute medius as much as we should, okay? So those lateral movements are not happening when we're exercising, so we've got to really make sure that we're keeping balance in all of the gluteal muscles, obviously, all the muscles in our body. We got four more. Three. Continue to tuck your hips under. Two. You're awesome. Keep it going. Good. Grab your right knee. Lift. Or you can just float your leg if that feels better for you. Please make sure that the left heel is driving into the earth. Your right foot can be pointed or flexed. It's really not going to make that much of a difference. Just notice. Make sure that your hips are lifting evenly and that you're not rotating your hips or rotating your spine at all. Good. Tuck your chin just a little bit. You may find that as you scoot, your chin is gonna jut up towards the ceiling. Good, three more. Exhale, inhale, two. Anyone feeling this yet? Hey, one, good. Switch, dig your heel in, lift. Man, it's so crazy, like, how much stronger my right side is. And I really try to, like, balance out when I'm riding and switching from right to left. But man, dominant legs really, you're really just mess up your body. So if you have one side that's much, much stronger, really pay attention and keep that balance with both legs or both arms or whatever it is, wherever you have dominance in your body. Good. Last one. Good. Okay. Lift. Tuck the tailbone under. Eminem just making this so much better. Keep it going. All right, here we go. Shake your ass. Good. Tuck your chin again. Show me what you're working with. You're breathing. Keep breathing. Lift higher. Come on. Ah. Two, one, good. Last set. Is this the last set? God, I feel like we've already done five of these. So I'm gonna just readjust because I'm just scooting myself right off the mat here. Lift. Good. Right leg up. Exhale. Really pressing through. Now, because I know that my right leg is stronger, I'm gonna hold my left leg more accountable on this set. Really powering through. I'm working a whole lot harder. Good. Exhale, lift. Again, tailbone is tucked under so that when you're landing, you don't have that space in your lower back. Keep it going. Eight. Seven. Relax your upper back. Four. Good. Exhale, lift. Two. One, good, switch. Eight, up, yep. Oh my God, my right side is just like, hey, I'm here to show off. I'll show you what you're working with. Oh God, I hope you guys can handle my corny jokes. It's like they come out as soon as I start lifting because I have to act like a goof. It's ridiculous. Good. Keep it going. Eight. Yes, you can. Seven. Lift it higher. Come on. Exhale high. Five. Go higher. Come on. Push your heel into the earth. Three. Two. And one. Good. Last time here. Okay, tuck your hips under. Four, three, two, lift your booty, come up. Good, focus, gluteus medius, right? We wanna see that booty from the front. This is how it happens. Shake your ass, lift, exhale, inhale. Tuck your chin, tuck your tailbone. You sing, it confuses the muscles. Good, squeeze tighter. I know that you can. We're not here to be mediocre. Come on, yes. Higher, tighter booty. We're on our way. Give me four, three, two, one. Good. Bring your knees into your chest. Nice. Little rock side to side. All right. Now, this is one that I love, 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 love. And I can attach my mic again. So grab your weights. And we're gonna stay kneeling on the mat. So if you have cranky knees, you might wanna fold the mat over two or three times or find something nice for you to kneel on. Okay, so you're down. Squeeze your butt at the top. Squeeze. Good. Abs tight. Good. Your knees are just a little bit wider than your hips. Your feet are coming a little bit closer. Good. Squeeze and tuck at the top. Good. Keep that going. Okay. Okay. We're going to set down our weights. I like to use them just to support my wrists. You can just rest your hands on the mat as well, but when I'm typically when I'm coaching, I want to offer different options for any wrist restrictions. So you're in your neutral spine, tabletop position. We start with our fire hydrant. So just lifting up, lift, release, exhale, inhale. Now, you want to lift as high as you can without compromising your form, okay? So exhale, inhale, and the other three things, you want to maintain your balance and stay equal on your weight distribution. We go two more, and you're going to straighten your leg, and you're going to pulse up right here. Take it up, lift, lift. Now think about creating an internal rotation with your leg. So you're sort of turning your knee in towards your midline. Keep it lifting, point your toe, and make sure that you're not dumping or coming down here. So everything stays strong and engaged. You can always rest on your forearms if you prefer. Good, now we're gonna draw a little rainbow with our foot. So it's just a tiny little arc. You start to feel a little bit of a burn, not only in your glutes, but your hamstrings here. Pull your belly button in towards your spine. Keep it going. Give me four, three, two. Back to your fire hydrant. Lift and lower. Exhale. Good. Now we're working the glutes, but I want you to think about the strength in your upper body, actively pressing away from the floor. Good. Now we're going to switch sides. Right here. Lift up. Lift. Good. Open up. Exhale. Every time you're giving your best effort, see how can you really execute the rep in the best way possible, keeping your arms strong, tiny little bend in the elbows. Three, exhale, yes. Good, straighten your leg, pulse it up, lift, 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 lift. Good. And you can close your eyes, you can imagine that beautiful bubble butt that we're growing. Keep it. Four, three, two, and one. Little arc. Over. Keep it going. Yep. And make sure that you're not dumping into your low back right here. Good. Lift up. Down. Yes, you can. Even distribution with your hands. You're not going to shift over to the opposite arm. You're stronger than that. Keep it going. Yep. Three. Back. Two. Lift. And one. Gorgeous. All right, coming back up. You've got your weights right here. Get ready. One, two, three. Up. One, two, three. Up. One, two, three, one, two, really squeeze at the top. Good, ha, good. Keep it going. Tuck your tailbone under. One, two, three, up. This is not our normal tempo. Good, big squeeze. Good, two, and one. Okay, we're gonna finish with a set of squats, okay? So, your feet are a little bit wider, down and up. Also, before I forget, do me a huge favor, will you guys let me know how many of you have bands, like the booty bands, like the loop? Because I'd like to do one of those classes, but I wanted to include everyone, so. We didn't use the bands today, but I'd love to do another class and use the bands. Good, abs tight. Squeeze your butt at the top. That's it, keep it going. Yep, down. Squeeze. Awesome. Two, and one. Three down, one up. Low, lower, lowest, up. Two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Up. Squeeze your butt at the top. Come on. One, two, three. One, two, three. Last one. Beautiful. All right. Take a deep breath in. Reach out and up. Good. Grabbing one wrist. Doesn't matter which one. We're just going to do a little side stretch here. Go to the other side. Good. And shake it out. A little quad stretch here. You've got your bike. Using that for balance. Good. Plugging your arm into your shoulder. Breathe in. Exhale out. Let it go. Okay. Little hip stretch here. Just taking your right foot across. See if you can sit a little bit lower. Really get into that stretch. Breathe into it and take some time here. Okay, I want for you to think of your muscles like tapping. You do anything fast, what does tapping do? It snaps. Okay, so we want to go slow. We want to be patient with the muscles. A little bit lower. Breathe. Awesome. All right. Quad stretch. Reach up. Find your balance. Find one point to focus on. Good. Feeling good. Hopefully you'll feel this tomorrow or the next day. Okay. Let's take it low. Doing the butt. Okay, now I know we are definitely running over on our time. Sit a little bit lower. We want to give it adequate time for both glutes. Good. Hands can be a prayer. They can reach out. You can be holding onto your bike for dear life. Whatever you got to do. A little lower. Inhale. Exhale out. Okay. Feet are wide. Toes turned in slightly. Surrender the weight of your head. Just grab, pull forward. Good, one hand down, extend the other arm up. Jazz hands, celebrate your workout. You are amazing. Marvel at your commitment. You are such an athlete, you are such a badass. Good, grab your elbows, little swing right here, little bend in the knees. Slowly, one vertebrae at a time, we roll up. Ha. All right, virtual high five. You know we gotta stand strong in our power pose here. Oh my God, my legs are shaking so bad. Okay, we look like a superhero, a shaky superhero, right? That's okay though. Close your eyes, feel good energy, feel the endorphins. You are amazing with gratitude. Breathe in, reach up tall. Capture that good, good energy, pull it to your heart. Keep it with you, share it with others. I love you guys. So strong. You kicked ass today. I will see you tomorrow. Bye.